I've got Dr. Banta in studio with me. I hope I got the name correct there. But our story there focused on jobs being created in Linden. We're talking about continuous development. COVID-19 is upon us. It's important that we have the conversation as it relates to moving forward and dispelling some of those myths. And I know you're one of the deans there at Texas University.
I'm the dean.
The dean there. Yeah. So we're going to be talking COVID-19. A lot has been said about COVID-19. A lot has been said about COVID-19 vaccines as well. Persons who have been asking questions relates to the safety of the vaccines. Persons have been asking whether or not young people with strong immune systems, if they can be affected by COVID-19. What would you say to those persons who may be asking those questions this morning?
Well, there are a few things we need to look into first before we start going into those questions. First of all, we have to remember that this is something very new for all of us. We have never had this virus before. So to predict with precision what's going to happen is almost impossible. You learn as you go forward.
Yeah.
Why I'm saying this? Because people get confused. First they were saying 2 weeks, now they're saying eight weeks. First they were saying they can be vaccinated, now they're saying they cannot be vaccinated. So they might feel like it gives an impression as if people don't know what's going on, which is not true. We are learning. Second thing about the vaccine that you said, people have to understand any vaccine that comes in the market or is offered by the government goes through a very rigorous clinical trial.
Mm-hmm.
There are three phases of clinical trial, phase one, phase two, phase three. Phase three is done among thousands of people.
Mm-hmm.
And the first concern in phase one is safety, whether it's safe, what dose is it safe.
Mm-hmm.
Then second trial, they do in hundreds of people to see whether it's effective and doing what it's supposed to do and giving immunity.
Yeah.
And the third phase, we do in thousands of people to see whether there are any rare side effects.
Mm-hmm.
So my point is that if the vaccine has landed up in the market, it has gone through this very rigorous clinical trial. So chances are that side effects or risks would be minimal. Yes, they will be there because there are some risks that manifest later on, but chances are very less.
Right. And I know persons may be concerned about the fact that the vaccines themselves have gone through, you mentioned a rigorous process, but in a short span of time, because the world was literally in a hurry and a rush to ensure that we come up with a solution, because the pandemic just hit us, everybody in the face, just like that. For those persons who are wondering and maybe asking themselves this morning, have you ever seen a rigorous process in terms of the development of vaccines before? Or is this the first time in terms of the time span for development of vaccines?
All the vaccines have gone through the same process that this vaccine has gone through.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, you are absolutely right. Maybe it was rushed, but that doesn't mean they compromise on any step.
Yeah.
You must have read this in news too, that many vaccines which did not publish the result of their phase 3 trial were not recommended by WHO.
Mm-hmm.
So they have not compromised on any step. Yes, it was done faster, but that's the importance of technology.
Yeah.
With technology, whatever we could do in a long time, we could do in shorter time.
Yeah.
So it doesn't mean that we have compromised on any of these steps.
Definitely.
I just wanted to assure everyone about that.
I'm happy that you would mention that. And we're talking technology, and there are two types of technology we use to develop the vaccines. We have the RNA and we have the mRNA vaccines. Let's talk about the difference as it relates to those two.
Well, there are four kinds of vaccine, to be precise. The age-old technique for which the vaccine have been developed for decades is the killed vaccine or inactivated vaccine.
Yeah.
Covaxin is the example, or Sinopharm, the China vaccine. These are the two vaccines which are example of killed vaccine or inactivated vaccine. Then the newer technique, as you mentioned, are the mRNA vaccine, which is a very new technique. Doesn't necessarily mean that it's compromised or anything.
Yeah.
Actually, the efficacy of mRNA vaccine has been much better as compared to other vaccines. Again, it has been tried and tested. So mRNA vaccine, which is your Pfizer and Moderna, which we are getting. Then there is what we call as vehicle vector vaccine, in which you take the genetic material of this virus and take another virus and put it inside that and then inject, which is your AstraZeneca vaccine. And then there is protein-based vaccine, which have not been Novavax and Covax are the example, in which you just take the protein of the virus and inject that.
Yeah.
No matter, so it might sound very complicated to people that what's going on, but the purpose is just the same.
Mm.
Whether you give a protein or genetic material or the virus inactivated or weakened, all of them do just one thing, that is create antibodies against coronavirus.
Mm.
That is common across all vaccines.
Yeah.
The mechanism might differ, but outcome is the same, that antibodies are prepared in your body. So when you get the actual virus infected, these antibodies, the army of antibodies are ready to defend you and fight it off.
Yeah. So for young people who are watching, and I know that young people, we oftentimes tell ourselves, you know, we're so immune to a lot of things, and because we're young and strong, what would you say to them? Because do we need that booster? Do we need our immune system to be given that booster as it relates to being given that extra protection?
And that's a good question and a usual concern. Whenever a crisis happens, you always try to categorize people into who needs it first for anything.
Yeah.
Even for organ transplant, as you know, we decide who, there may be a long list, but you have to decide who needs this first, right? Yeah. Same thing happened here too. Vaccines were limited in number. So when something is limited, I wish we had enough to give it to everyone right away, but that's not the fact. So when that is the case, you have to decide who needs it first. And it was a consensus among the scientists of the world that the young, they have a robust immune system. They have enough antibodies to fend it off. And as such, infections were not seen in them. All the infections were seen in elderly, you know, above 60, above 50, those people. So that's why the decision was made that, you know, maybe since infection is not being seen in them, let us not immunize them for now.
Yeah.
And I'm pretty sure in very near future, we'll start immunizing young people too.
Yeah, I could agree with you. My final question before we wrap this up here. Persons that are watching may still have vaccine hesitancy, and or how important is it for persons, for the entire population, to be serious or seriously thinking about getting vaccinated if we're to return to life as normal?
It's very, very important. I would say it's vital. Nothing else seems to be working. To be honest with you, there is hardly any treatment that has been proven to be effective. Virus is there. You cannot deny that anymore. It's spreading. Okay?
Yeah.
So the question is, what can we do? If there was a treatment, I would say, okay, don't get vaccinated. There's a treatment. If you, for example, tuberculosis.
Mm-hmm.
You get tuberculosis, I have a treatment that I know that works. Unfortunately, that's not true in the case of virus.
Mm-hmm.
So our only defense mechanism against virus is to get vaccinated. And one more thing I'll say, when you get vaccinated, you're not just protecting yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You're protecting your family, you're protecting your community, you're protecting your country.
Yeah.
Because any potential candidate which is not vaccinated can spread the virus to others who are not vaccinated.
Yeah.
So the more get vaccinated, the better. That's what I would say.
Yeah, important enough there. Thank you so much for the information there, Doc. It was a pleasure talking to
My
you this
pleasure.
Morning.